Right. Hello and welcome to a test stream of Elite Dangerous Horizons Beta 2.2 Beta 4. I am in a beluga liner and I am some random system, I don't remember where. But I'll just be messing around and recording for a little while, so we'll see what happens. Now I'm using a DK2, Oculus DK2, which is a second generation prototype of a VR headset that were around $350 US at the time. Much cheaper than current tech, but it's lower res than the current stuff. Low resolution, 1080p monitor inside the headset, but it works great with Elite still, and most other VR games that it's capable of playing with. Cool thing about it is to open up the menus, I just have to look in that direction. Now, let's see. I'll show you external of the beluga liner. It's the biggest ship that you can fly in the game so far. The cockpit in VR, which is right there, when you're inside it, it looks like it looks like you're sitting in a giant living room. Well, it feels like that and looks like that. But yeah, the beluga liner in all its glory. Anyway, I have outfitted it with Class A everything that I could think of putting on it, and it has two launchable fighters, so I'm going to try that out now. Alright. And I want to fly it.
Stand by for deployment, Commander.
So now I'm in the bay.
Fighter deployed. Flight assist off.
Alright, I have to learn how to keep him from following me. As you can see, the blue is a big ship, but it's still very maneuverable. Target, engage at will, maintain formation, hold position.
Copy, holding position.
So now I can have a good look at him. This little ship. My joystick is a bit squeaky. It's a really old 5-year-old Saitek X52.
Flight assist off.
Yeah, when this patch comes out, it's gonna be really, really, really big game changer. The ship launch fighters. See my zigzags there, I'll follow them along. Switch between the two. I'm not going to do that. But what I will do is get an external view. There we go. Beluga liner and a little Imperial fighter ship. I forget what it's called. Right. What do I do? How do I get docking permission? Maybe. Ah, there we go. Orders. Nope. Orders. Fighters. Quest dock. There we go.
Throttling down for retrieval, Commander.
Already throttled down. Oops. Got shields, I'm not hurt. And just fly into the blue thing. Autopilot takes over. Back in the mothership. Forgot what weapons I put on this. Let's have a look.
Power plant capacity exceeded.
Power plant capacity exceeded. Let's have a look at my modules. Switched off my fuel scoop. Really need to do some power management, but that's alright. Modules, fire groups. I cannot fire for some reason. Let's see if my trick is even working. Yep. Hmm. It's because they're turreted. They need to be locked onto something to fire. Alright, it's a disappointment. Because it's my bad for outfitting it with turrets. Alright. Now I'll show you a cool new feature about hyperspace. Galaxy map. I'll pick a destination. Go to Anim, an Imperial location. They still haven't fixed the galaxy map in VR. That cursor never aligns with the 3D menu. Slightly out of alignment from the star system on Lido. And hyperdrive. High security, high checking tells me if I'm clean in that sector, which is useful. Means I got no bounty there, no crimes.
Ready to engage.
Align. So if I slightly align. Quickly take over. And this is the new cool thing. When you're in hyperspace, you can see the star coming towards you, or you going towards it, or however hyperspace works, God only knows. Class Red Dwarf.
Fuel scooping.
Just refueling a wee bit for the hell of it. So let's go to Debiago port or something like that. I have my orbit lines turned off. The Viago port. There's a planet. Going around 2 megameters a second. That doesn't align. Alright, Mr. Man. Quest docking.
Your docking request has been approved. Please head directly to docking bay 10.
This is a good example of how to fly the biggest ship in the game through the mail slot.
4,000 meters from touchdown.
Flight desist.
Just like that. How to land it. And this is cool. The station's changed completely. It's clearly high tech or something. And you get down. Yeah. It's very futuristic in here. The red docking numbers. That's new as well. Yeah, it's all different in here. Starport services. Okay. Refuels on this side. Yeah. Restart. Can I check one on here? So we got crew lounge. This is where you hire pilots. UI takes a while to load. I don't know if it's procedurally generating the avatars or loading up the server. Most likely loading it from a server. Now this is a new feature of 2.2. By loading the passenger lounge. So we've got a bunch of factions to choose from. Keep in mind I'm using a 660 GDX. Let's change the pace of the music. Don't know if I want to do a passenger mission.
Of reality, are we projecting out there ourselves?
got radio missions. How's this change? Is this the same? The regular mission board is exactly the same. Yeah, this is a high-tech station. High-tech economy.
The way that I experience the world is my world is completely colored differently than yours.
Lots of characters. Let's find the shortest passenger mission. Here it should say does not react well to danger, hull damage will dramatically reduce passenger satisfaction, laid back laser unlikely to affect passenger, low value target passenger is unlikely to be sought by hostile forces, neutral performing illegal actions will slightly reduce passenger satisfaction, demanding highly to make demands while on board. Denying these requests will reduce passenger satisfaction. Okay. So where do I have to go? According to this. This one here. I'll lock that in. Undock the beluga liner. There
you go. Your ship is released. Depart when ready.
Landing gear.
Yeah, up. See how fast I can make the station. Here we go. Only in VR.
Scan detected.
Scan.
Facility boundary exceeded. Imperial Flight Operations Bureau wishes you a fond farewell.
Station. Mass slot. Go.
Frameshift drive charging.
Thank you.
Steve speaking.
Let's use some fuel while I check the map for the mission location. Go. Now it is 16,000 light seconds away, so Super Cruise is going to take a little while. Wonder what Discovery Scanner is not needed here, but I like the sound it makes, so I'll do it anyway. There we go. Alright, while on Super Cruise. Good external. Turn the camera around. There it goes. Unfathomable speeds. Now in VR you do feel really, really tiny when you look at this thing. Let's head back to the cockpit. Five times the speed of light right now. I should be there pretty soon. Let's have a look at the system map. See what's changed. Okay. Now I'll tell you straight away, this is not the scale, although these planets do look small next to the star, they are not scale. The star is probably 100 times bigger, and these planets are probably much, much different in size. It's an ammonia-rich ringed planet. This is where I'm headed. Oh wow, they have the surface on them now. Oh, that's cool. Used to zoom in and all you'd see was a grid. Alright, I'm getting pretty close now, so need to concentrate. Passenger hasn't made any demands. Good. slowing down. Let's try the 6 second rule, 7 second rule. Oh, this looks cool, I'm being interdicted. Now if I can't evade it, this is gonna be fun as hell. I can't be bothered fighting, so I'm gonna try to evade. Easy as that. Back to the location. I don't want to upset my passenger. Just for research. I'm running a 660 GDX, so my graphics aren't the greatest. VR, it looks fine. Limitations, you know. So far, it looks like the planet's procedurally generating just fine. CD'd itself.
Orbital flight engaged.
Should sharpen up. It's a 0.15G planet. Can't wait to get a better graphics card so I can generate these planets a lot quicker. There we go, dropping into glide. There's the pause for it to load. See the station. Right at docking or good stretch.
Sir Kruger, India, November, Foxtrot. This is flight control. Please follow established docking procedures and request access before you approach the port.
Now I'll do a little docking tutorial. Always request docking before actually docking. Otherwise you won't be actually docking, you'll be actually being shot at. Always face the right direction on the landing pad, which I am not right now, because you can tell the number is closest to me. The number should be at the front end of the ship when we land.
Reduce your speed now, Commander.
Yes, I'll reduce my speed now, Russian future guy. So I'll turn around. There's some shot. Watch out this building. Go back forward. Yeah, now I'm facing the right way. Make sure you're seated and balanced. Not moving too fast. This thing is weird. Devs, make this thing easier to dock. Now let's get rid of my passenger.
Contact, docking restraints engaged. Hope can be of service, Commander.
And that was a really easy 75,000 credits. Pretty sure it can get easier and more rewarding than that as well. I'll end the recording in a minute. Just gonna see what this incoming message was. Alright, reputation change. Now let's go back to external view before I... before I stop it. Thank you for watching. Just watch this ship fly away. AI driven type 7 by the look of it. And it bursts off. Good night, everyone.